Okay, so what are captions? So there are stories or sentences accompanying the photos. They complement with what a reader may view about the picture. So meaning, kung may picture tayo, dapat yung caption natin is about the picture presented. Hindi yung iba yung istorya na ating ilalahad doon sa ating caption. So they should complement the picture and also the caption. So captions are of three parts. So tandaan natin yung tatlong mga bahaging ito ng captions natin. So the first one, we have the what we call the catch line. So it is the title of the caption, usually in boldface and in capital letters. So capital letters, bale, and then usually it may consist of one word or a phrase. So pwedeng isang salita lang, pwede ring parirala or a phrase. So that is for the catch line. And capital letters, all capital letters. Then the second is the cut line or the body. So it is usually a sentence telling the who, what, where, when, why, and the how of events. So bale, ito na yung istorya. Nasabi nga kanina ni Sir Gerald, para tayong gumagawa rito ng news. Because yung trend ngayon in our captioning, it's more on news yung captioning natin. Before, yung pinakasikat is on feature. Nag-featureize tayo. But then it depends also, ha? It depends kung anong ipagagawa talaga sa atin ng examiner. Kasi sometimes, hindi natin alam, yung iba talagang action yung pinagagawa, gumagawa tayo ng news story. Kung minsan naman, feature naman yung pinagagawa sa atin. So much better if you're going to train our campus journalist with these two. Captioning using the news and also the feature. And then the third one is credit or source. So magkalilimutan yan, especially in our school paper. In the contest, no need of writing the caption, the credit or the source because our contestants really are doing the work. Hindi naman yung advisor ang gumagawa ng pictures na kinakailangan i-credit sa advisor or the trainer, di ba? Sila naman ang gumagawa ng o kumukuha ng pictures. So but in our school publication or school paper, so talagang dapat isulat doon kung sino talaga yung kumuha ng picture ng larawan. So it tells who took the photos or the source of the photos. Okay, so again, remember these three parts in our caption. So sa ating school paper, bawat larawan dapat may caption. So again, the three parts are, we have the catch line. Kaya nga yung pagkakasulat ko rin dito, it is in bold letters, no? Okay, catch line. Then we have the cut line or the body. And the third one, we have the credit or the source. Okay, so writing the captions. How are we going to write the captions? So I have here an example. So answering the five W's. So what? So we have here a corpse. Then who? Landslide victim. At saka we also have the BFP reshooting. Then where? In Payatas, Quezon. Then when? Yesterday. And then why? Covered by garbage. Kung gagawa tayo halimbawa ng caption using this information, so paano kaya magagawa? Paano natin gagawin yung caption? So, and again, you're going to write a catch line for this. So, I have here an example also kung paano yung gagawin. Example. So, yung ginawa natin ritong catch line is unfortunate soul. Okay? Unfortunate soul. So, bali, yung ating cut line dito is a dead body of a young male was uncovered from a sea of garbage by members of BFP rescue team in Payatas, Quezon yesterday. So, yan bali yung ating halimbawa para sa ating caption. And then, sabi nga rito, photo by. Okay, so syempre pa, kung halimbawa ito ay school paper, you're going to place this one, photo by. But then, as I've said, in the contest, no need of writing this one, photo by. O yung tinatawag natin credit or source. Okay, so how to write good captions in photojournalism? So, take note of this, no? On how to write good captions in photojournalism. So, captioning photos is an important part of journalism. Walang kalatoy-latoy ang larawan kapag halimbawa walang caption. Walang paliwanag tungkol sa larawan. So, what will happen if there's no caption? So, marami ang pwede nating interpretation na magagawa sa larawan dahil walang caption. But then, captions must be accurate and informative. Mamaya malalaman natin kung bakit tinawag itong accurate at saka informative. Okay, so in fact, most readers tend to look at the photos and then the captions. So yung una muna, titingnan yung larawan, yung mga readers natin. Pagkatapos talagang babasahin nila yung captions. In a story, before they decide whether they want to read the story itself. Kapag interesting yung picture natin at saka yung caption, talagang babasahin ng readers yung news. Okay. So use the following points to help write a caption that will intrigue the reader enough to read the story. So bali ito yung gagamitin nating mga points to make the picture and also, yes, to make the picture interesting. So number one, check your facts. Ano ba yung totoo? So one of the most important aspects of any type of journalism is accuracy. So if you see incorrect information, incorrect information, the story or photo loses credibility. So dapat yung katotohanan lamang. Pawang katotohanan lamang, parang GMA. Okay, so before uploading or printing any photo captions, make sure you've checked that anything is stated in the caption is accurate. Totoo lahat yung nakasulat sa caption. Don't print an incorrect caption if you have trouble checking your facts. Huwag ka muna magka-caption if you are not really sure na totoo yung ika-caption mo doon. So either because you can't find an appropriate source or because you're on a deadline. Example, in the contest, talagang it's only 1 hour. So nagmamadali na yung bata. So gawa na lang siya ng caption kahit hindi totoo. Malalaman din yan ng ating mga judges kung totoo yung caption niya o hindi. Okay. So instead, describe details of the photo that are not obvious. Sorry. It's better to leave the information out if you aren't sure it's accurate. So in photojournalism, it's important that your captions be as objective and descriptive as possible. Try not to put your own emotions into it. Just tell a factual story. Huwag mong isasama ang sarili mo dahil ikaw ay nalulungkot, dahil ikaw ay, parang bagang nakikisimpatiya sa larawan, pati yung emotion mo ilalagay mo doon sa caption. Okay, just tell the fact. So, number one, again, check your facts. Number two, describe something that isn't obvious. Kung anong nakikita, huwag mo nang sabihin kasi nakikita na siya. So, if a photo caption simply describes the visuals in the photo, it's fairly useless. Kung nakikita na, nag-describe ka pa, wala nang gamit yung caption mo. So, if you have a photo of a sunset, example, no? And simply caption it as a sunset, you're not adding any additional information for the reader. Kasi alam nila, sunset yan eh. Instead, describe details of the photo that are not obvious. Like, halimbawa, no? The location, you state the location, the time of day or year, or a specific event that is taking place. For instance, if you have a photo of a sunset, you might want to caption it as Manila Bay Sunset, March 2020. Okay. So kung halimbawa, yun ang caption mo. So also avoid using terms like is shown, is pictured, and looks on or above. Okay. So ito naging problema ko dati sa isa kong contestant in photojournalism. Nang basahin ko yung kanyang entry for the regional press conference, photojournalist ko siya. Nang tingnan ko, nagsimula siya sa makikita sa larawan, sabi ko, agoy, mariyawan na. Wala siya sa inig. Ba't gagamitin pa yung makikita sa larawan? Wag na. Do not use, is shown, is pictured, and looks on or above. Okay. So number three. Do not start a caption with certain words. Again, do not start a caption with certain words. So usually, certain words pertains to the articles. Mga aan, at saka yung da. But then, if needed, pwede naman gamitin. Because there are instances na yung sentence natin needs really to start with aan, at saka yung da. Diba? So a caption should not begin with the words an or the. These words are too basic and take up valuable captioning room when they aren't necessary. Okay, for example, instead of saying a blue jay in the boreal forest, so we can simply say blue jay flying through boreal forest. So pwede natin gawan para hindi magamit yung mga article sa yan. But then sabi ko kanina, kung halimbawa hindi maiwasan, gamitin na rin natin. The most important thing is tama yung caption na ginawa natin. Okay, also do not start a caption with the name of someone. Start the caption with a description first and then include the name. Okay, for example, don't say, example to ha, is Tanterman near Sunshine Meadow Park. Instead, pwede natin gamitin, Jagger is Tanterman near Sunshine Meadow Park. Then when identifying where someone is in a photo, you can say from left, but never say from left to right. Kasi from left, meaning papunta na yun sa right. Huwag nang sabihin pa from left to right, from left na lang. Okay, so number four, identifying the main people in the photo. So mahalaga to, dapat alam natin kung sino ang kasali doon sa picture. Okay. So if your photo includes important people, identify who they are. If you know their names, include them. Unless they've asked to remain anonymous. So huwag mong pagpipilitang isulat ang pangalan nila kung ayaw nila. Okay. If you don't know their names, you might want to put a description of who they are instead. Diba? Example, protesters on the streets of Washington, D.C. Kumbaga, i-contextualize natin, protesters on the streets of EDSA, Manila. Okay. So, another, while it shouldn't need to be said, make sure any and all names you use are spelled correctly and have the proper title. So, be careful with the spelling of the names. If the photo includes a group of people, or some people who are not relevant to the story, so their names are not required to tell the story, you do not have to name each of them in the caption. Yung mahalaga lamang, yung prominent people lamang, pwede yun ang ating ilagay doon sa ating caption. Then identify also the people in the picture, sabi ko kanina. Identify them from left followed by their full names. In kuwang din niya yun. So, anong gagawin natin? So, we have to begin with the front row. Simulan doon sa front. If the people are in a circle, nakaikot yung ayos nila, yung kinuna na picture. So, paano gagawin yun? Kasi circle naman sila. So, have the caption, read from left, then clockwise. Yung pagbanggit ng kanilang pangalan. So, simulan sa left, tapos clockwise yung ating pagbibigay o pagka-caption sa kanila using their names. Okay. So, number five. Be as specific as possible. This advice goes hand in hand with being accurate. If you are unsure of where the photo was taken or who is in the photo, find out. So alamin mo kung sino ang nandyan sa ating photo. Okay. Showing a photo without any specific information may not be useful to the reader, especially if you cannot inform them of the context in which the photo was taken. So if you were working with another journalist for the story, say, for example, you're going to use a photo in your school paper. Not during the contest, huh? Because it is only the contestant who will take the photo. So contact them for more information if needed. If you are trying to identify a specific person in the photo, describing where in the photo they are is best useful. For example, if Bob Smith is in the only one in a hat, you can say Bob Smith back row in hat. Okay, so lamang siya lang nakasombrero tapos nandoon siya sa likod. So when specific is good, you can also phrase your caption so that it starts general and becomes more specific, or starts specific and ends more generally. Either method ensures specificity but creates easy to read statements. So from specific to general or from general to specific. So number six, label historical photos properly. If you were using a historical photo in your story, make sure it's labeled properly and includes the date, at least kung hindi mo alam yung exact date, the year it was taken. Depending on who owns the photo, you may also need to credit another photography and or organization. So pwede mong ma-mention yung photography at saka yung organization who took the picture. Number seven, use the present tense in captions. So itong mahalaga, especially sa ating mga contestants and also in our paper. Use the present tense in captions. Okay, because most photos being shown as part of a news story are of things happening right now, use the present tense in the caption. So always remember, in captioning, even our school reports, diba, in our ACR, we use the present tense, not the past tense. So an obvious exception would be an historical photos where using the past tense makes sense. Yung historical lang, alam naman maging present tense na napakatagal nang nangyari yung photo na yon. Okay. Okay, so the nice thing about using the present tense is that it portrays a sense of immediacy and increases the impact of the photo on the reader. Number eight, avoid humor when the photo isn't intended to be humorous. Huwag maging katawa-tawa, huwag gawing katatawanan yung larawan. If the photo you're captioning is of a serious or somber event, don't try to be funny in the caption. So huwag gawing katatawanan. Funny caption should only be used when the photo itself is a joke or of a funny event that is intended to make the reader laugh. Number nine, remember to always include credits and citations. Itong mahalaga, especially in our school organ, in our school paper. Always include the credits and citation. So every photo should include the name of the photographer and or the organization that owns the photograph. In actual photographic magazines and publications, photos are also include the technical details of how the photo was taken. So when writing the credits, sabi nga rito, you don't have to use the term credited to, photo by. But then in our school organ, ginagamit pa rin natin itong photo by or credited to. Pwede rin naman kasing gamitin, sabi rito, the information is presented in a consistent and understandable format. For example, maybe the credits are always italized or are a smaller font size. Meaning after your caption, then period, the last words there is the credit, yung pangalan talaga ng kumuha ng larawan. Okay, now, how are we going to enhance the story with captions? So ito, pagpapa-enhance na ito, pagpapaganda na ito ng ating story na may caption. So number one, use the caption to tell the reader something new. Dapat bago. So when a reader looks at the photo, they're usually confronted with some form of emotions and some information based on what they see in the photo. The caption, in turn, should provide the reader with a piece of information they were unaware of from simply looking at the photo. So nagbibigay tayo ng karagdagang impormasyon mula sa larawan. Kaya sabi nga rito kanina, huwag sabihin yung nakikita na. Okay, do not tell the obvious. So in short, the caption should teach the reader something about the photo. So captions should intrigue a reader to investigate the story further and look for more information. And captions should also refrain from repeating aspects of the story itself. The caption and the story should complement each other and not be repetitive. Hindi pa ulit-ulit na lang. Number two, avoid making judgmental statements. Captions should be informative, not judgmental or critical. Unless you were actually able to speak to the people in the photo and ask them what they were feeling or thinking, don't make assumptions based only on their appearance in the photo. Example, nakita ka ng isang taong umiiyak, nagyayakapan sila, sasabihin mo sad na sila. How about halimbawa, ngayon lang sila nagkita, nagyayakapan sila, tuwang-tuwa sila, alam naman nating mga Pilipino, tayo nalulungkot, tayo natutuwa, umiiyak tayo. Diba? Okay. So baka kasi ang ating sasabihin doon, unhappy or sad. So for example, avoid unhappy shoppers waiting in line unless you actually know they were unhappy. So journalism is intended to be objective and informative for the reader. So journalists are supposed to present the facts, sabi ko kanina, in an unbiased way and allow the reader to form an opinion. Okay, number three, do not worry about length of the caption. A photo may say 1,000 words, but sometimes a few words are required to put the photo in context. But dinabasa ko yung kung ano yung ating guidelines in captioning 2020. Yung bagong guidelines. So I have read there na yung caption, 2 sentences nga ang nakalagay doon. Pwedeng gumamit ng 2 sentences. Anyway, I'm going to present that later, yung tungkol sa pagka-caption. Kasi nakasanayan natin when it comes to captioning, especially in the contest, it's only 1 sentence. Yun ang karaniwan natin ginagawa. Okay. Number 4, write in a conversational language. So journalism in general doesn't use overly complicated language, but it also doesn't use cliche or slang. Captions should follow the same basic language requirements. So write your captions in a conversational tone, similar to the way you'd address a family member if you're showing them in a photo. So avoid, sabi nga dito, cliche and slang. Don't use complicated words if they aren't needed. So if the photo is accompanied by a story, try to use the same tone in the caption that was used in the story. Kung masaya yung larawan, caption mo, masaya. Pero kung halimbawa, masaya, tapos yung caption mo, sad, so iba na yun. Okay. So sabi nga natin, the picture, the photo, and the caption should complement with each other. Number 5, include unessential story items in the captions. Yung tinatawag nating unessential story, ha, maaaring ito yung mga behind the scene, kumbaga, na hindi nakita sa news, but then alam mo na ito yung nangyari, you can include that one. Stories that accompany photos tend to be about something specific and obviously tell a story. If there is a piece of information that is useful to understanding the photo but isn't necessary in telling the story, put it in a caption instead of in the body of the story. So pwede natin gamitin yun just in case you really know about the story. Number 6, determine what punctuation should be used. Usually, yung punctuation mark na ginagamit natin, period. After the sentence, period. Okay, if the photo is simply a person, a headshot, example, or a photo of a very specific item, an umbrella, it's okay to caption the photo with the name of the person or item without any punctuation. Umbrella lang, tapos lagay ka pa ng period. Wag na, di ba? And then also, if it's only a picture of a person, kasi yun ang ginamit mo doon, you can write the family name also as your caption. Or bit yet, you can write the full name of the person presented. Okay. Already number 6, no? So, number 7. Simplify descriptions in subsequent captions. If multiple consecutive photos in a story show either the same place or person or event, it is not necessary to keep repeating the details of these items in its caption. So, we can use this one in our school publication, in our school organ. So, for example, If you introduce the person in the first caption using their full name, you can simply refer to them with their last name in subsequent captions. It is okay to assume that someone viewing and reading one photo have viewed and read the captions of the previous photos, since they are likely in a specific order that tells a story. Okay, number 8. Considering using a caption writing formula. So ito na, mahalaga to. Dapat meron tayong caption writing formula. In writing a caption using the news. Kumbaga, news captioning gagamitin natin. We have a formula for that. So until you get used to writing captions, you might want to start by using a specific formula. Eventually, your captions will likely follow this formula or something similar without you needing to think about it. Lalabas na lamang yun, just in case you are used to it. But until then, rely on the formula to ensure you've included all the needed items. Kagaya halimbawa nung na-present ko kanina before I started the session. Di ba may example akong inilagay doon? Answering the 5 W's. Kasama pa nga doon yung 1 H in our captioning. Okay, so this is now the formula. One such formula is, we have the noun, noun muna yung una, then the verb, then direct object, then during, then proper event name, yung pangalan ng event na di-describe mo, at then proper noun or location, yun ang kasunod, in, kung city man yan, on, day of the week. So yung date na, then month, that's for the date, then year, then why or how. So that is the formula. Okay, we have here an example. Okay, using the formula. Dallas firefighters, that's the noun. Battle, that is now the present tense verb. A fire, okay, that is the direct object. At the Fitzhugh apartments, that's the proper noun location. Okay, yun ang lugar. Near the intersection of Fitzhugh Avenue and Monarch Street in Dallas, that's the city. On Thursday, so yung day of the week muna. July, that's the month. Then 1, that's the date. And then 2004, that is the year. So try to teach our writers on captioning using this formula. Magagamit nila to para at least hindi sila malilito pa paano ba ako magka-caption sa news. Especially mga action naman talaga yung trend ngayon, action pictures ang ipinagagawa sa mga bata, pinagkukuha sa mga bata when it comes to competition. So again, try to teach our campus journalists using this formula para hindi sila mahirapan kung paano ba sila magka-caption. Okay, now, avoiding caption mistakes. Ito yung mga mistakes na dapat nating avoid in captioning. So number 1, do not be arrogant. Huwag tayong arrogante. So paano malalaman na tayo arrogante when it comes to captioning? So arrogance in captions comes when the person writing the caption doesn't care about the reader and simply writes a caption that is easy at the moment of writing. Ibig sabihin, hindi pinag-isipan ang kanyang caption. Okay, so we should be careful. Sabi nga natin kanina, so dapat we should tell the fact about the picture. So kung fact ang gusto mong lumabas, dapat kumpleto yung kung ano yung information. Okay. This can also be considered being selfish, kumbaga, because the writer cares more about themselves than the reader who is trying to decipher what the photo and story are about. This can also happen when a writer is trying to be fancy and try something new or clever. There is no need to get complicated. Keep things simple, clear, and accurate. So again, we should be accurate with the information. Number 2, avoid making assumptions. So nasabi ko na ito kanina. So don't make assumptions about what was going on in the photo or who the people are. Find out the truth and only include what's accurate. Okay, so this also goes for style and format. If you aren't sure if the publication has a specific format or for captions, you have to ask. Don't use a format you like that may need to be completely revised later because you didn't ask. So alamin ang format na ginagamit in captioning. So number 3. Make sure you aren't sloppy. So sloppiness happens when someone just doesn't care or doesn't consider the situation important enough to double check. So meaning we have to double check our entry. The result of sloppiness can be incorrect spellings. Ito na, be careful again with the spelling. The wrong names for people in the photo. Captions that don't match the photo. Referring to a photo in the story incorrectly. Iba na yung story mo doon sa inyong caption about the photo. If you're proud of your work, do a good job from start to finish. This can also happen when someone tries to use another language in the caption but doesn't check if it has been written properly. Okay, number 4. Remember that what you print is considered fact. So kung anong na-print mo, kung sino magbabasa nun, yun ang paniniwalaan ng mga tao. So as a journalist, whatever you print either in your story or caption is usually considered fact by your readers. They rightfully assume you've done your fact checking and that what you're telling them is accurate. So if you were too lazy or sloppy to do the job, you risk passing along incorrect information to a large number of people. Also remember that once information gets out there, na ilabas na, kumbaga na publish na, it can be hard to correct, especially if that information is related to an event that was tragic, stressful, or still ongoing. So those are the four items that should be avoided in our captioning. So I have here example of pictures. So nakuha ko rin ito sa Google. So mapapansin natin, so nandyan yung tinatawag nating tatlong parts of a caption. So again, ano ba yung tatlong parts of the caption? So we have the catch line. So nandito yung catch line niya, jobs wanted. Then kasunod, yun na yung tinatawag nating cut line or the body. At saka, yung nasa katapusan nito, alay sa salin, siya ang credit or source. Hindi na sinunod dito yung photo by. Pero pwede pa rin naman natin gamitin yun ang nakasanayan natin. We actually write the word photo by or credited by. Or credited to, I mean. Okay, next picture. Okay, this one. Okay, so the catch line there is disconnection. So ito sinasabi ko, pwedeng one word lang yung ating catch line. So disconnection. So nandyan na yung cut line or the body. Manila Electric Company linemen switch off the overhead power meters of some Makati City households after failing to settle power bills. The power distribution firm has recently announced a cut in monthly power charges following a decrease in generation and transmission charges. So we'll notice it's composed of two sentences. And then again, ang kumuha ng larawan ay si Eliza Salim. Okay, this one, this picture, mapapansin natin wala siyang catch line. Yung nandito lamang yung kanyang cut line or body and then at saka yung credit or source. But then, for our contest, for the contestants, please always tell them to write a catch line. Okay. Then, general guidelines for the selection of winners in photojournalism. So itong ginamit natin, DepEd Memorandum No. 176, Series 2019. Okay, bago pa ito nag-pandemic. Although nagkaroon ng contest during the pandemic, but then it was online. Okay, so ito yung ginamit during the 2020 in SPC. Okay, so ito rin ang dapat isaalang-alang natin, ha? Okay, in training our students. So preparation for the preparation. So number one, contestants should be at the contest venue 30 minutes before the orientation of the guide on the guidelines and rubrics. The same also in the lower competition. In our area, I think not much in area, but in the division. So talagang gagamitin natin to in the division press conference, in the regional, and most especially in Kuan, in the national press conference. So dapat, tanda na yung ating mga bata, 30 minutes dapat nandun na sa ating contest venue. Number two, the contestants are allowed to use any digital camera point and shoot only. So nasabi niyan kanina Sir Gerald, with a maximum of 20.1 megapixels with fixed lenses only. Contestants who will use any DSLR and other high-end cameras will not be permitted to join the contest. So huwag magdadala ng DSLR during the contest. Isa rin ito sa mga naging problema namin dati. May mga kwan daw, 20.1 megapixels lang na camera, pero ba't parang may mga lens sila? So dapat walang lens, ha? Kasi madi-disqualified yung bata. Talagang point and shoot lang talaga. Okay, number three, the contestants shall format their own memory card and camera to be checked by the examiners. So before, usually, no, before the contest, a day before the contest, talagang ipapasabit na sa kanila, sa ating mga examiners yung memory card. Okay, pinadadala yun, inilalagay sa cellophane, inilalagay ng pangalan para hindi mawala. And then the contestant can retrieve the memory card during talaga sa contest. Doon ibibigay para hindi na malagyan pa mga pictures yung memory card. So number four, the contestant should bring his or her own camera cable for saving a picture. So dapat magdala ng sariling camera cable, hindi manghihiram from other contestants. Okay, number five, cellular phones, extra digital cameras, extra storage card, or any additional materials or equipment are not allowed in the contest area. So yung dala-dala talaga nila ay ang kanilang camera at saka yung memory card na ibinalik sa kanila. No other gadgets. Number six, contestants shall bring their own black ink ballpen while the NTWG, NTWG ha, kasi yung ginamit nating guidelines is coming from the national. We'll provide scratch papers where contestants can write down notes during the shooting. So pwede rin dito sa ating division press conference, pwede rin magbigay ng papel o band paper yung ating TWG. Okay, just in case na mayroon siyang pwedeng isulat na magagamit nila in their captioning. Number seven, contestants shall set the date and time of their own camera. So dapat nakaset na yung kanilang camera sa date and time. Okay, letter B, this is for photoshoot, uploading, and captioning. So this is during the contest. Control shot shall be the first shot. May tinatawag kasi tayong control shot. So train your pupils or your students regarding this control shot. Usually, yung tinatawag nating pagkuha ng control shot, depende yon during the orientation before the contest begin. Nagkakaroon kasi muna ng orientation. Pag sinabi ng ano to, nagbibigay ng examiner natin o ng judges natin or facilitator, pag sinabing yung control shot nyo ay ako. Okay, napansin ko yan kasi in my contestants, previous contestants, na yung kanilang control shot ay yung nagsasalita mismo. Yung nakukunan. Yung iba sasabihin, the control shot is the stage. The control shot is this building. So yun dapat ang unang larawan na kukunan ng bata. Okay, number two. Contestants are given 1 hour to take pictures. Isang oras lamang, which does not include the loading and unloading of the storage card in front of the examiner on a theme to be provided during the orientation. So yung theme natin ay bibigay during the orientation. And usually, yung expenses namin when it comes to theme, parang word lang. In Tacloban, yung ginamit nila dyan sa Tacloban, the word is kuan, resiliency. Bahal na yung magbatang mag-isip, ano ba kukunan niya using that word, resiliency. Kaya naman dito yung bata ko pagkatapos niya kumuha ng picture, sino mo sa matong awoy yung gamit? Bahala ka, kayo ang kantistan. Hindi niya alam kung ano ba, tama ba yung kinunan niya, mga larawan or ano. So yun, dapat, we have to train our pupils. So kukuha rin tayo, although this is taking pictures, sabi nga nila, taking pictures only. But it is not only. Ibig sabihin, kinakailangan kukuha rin tayo ng mga bata na magagaling, matatalino. Kasi hindi yan lamang pagkuha ng larawan. Gagamit din yan ng utak when it comes to processing. Ano bang kukunan kong larawan using the word? Diba? And then, how am I going to caption yung larawang nakuha ko? Tapos related to the theme. So dapat, kahit pagkuha lang yan ng larawan, matalinong bata ang ating kukunin na contestant para dyan. Okay. Kailangan kasi yan ng pag-iisip din. Okay, number three. Contestants are allowed to take unlimited shots. Ito bali ito ha. Bali ito doon, nakabata ito sa ating guidelines. 2019 na guidelines na ginamit sa 2020 in SPC. Kasi dati, 10 pictures lamang ang pwedeng kunan ng bata. But then, it is stated here, they are allowed to take unlimited shots. Bisang pila pwede, kahit ilan pwede. But still, submit 5 possible photos with caption for the given theme and the control shot. So kung isipin natin to, ilang larawan ang dapat matira doon sa kanyang camera? So mayroong 6 na larawan. Okay, ang gagawin kasi sa ibang larawan, so i-delete niya yung ibang larawan at dapat ang matira doon ay 6 na lamang. So 5 pictures na kinuha niya plus the control shot. Baka kasi isipin na lamang niya na 5 na lang yung matitira. So kapag halimbawa nag-layout na siya, 5 pictures na lang nandun. So kulang na yung larawan niya, so wala na. Disqualified na. Okay, kasi kulang yung kanyang picture. So 5 pictures, possible photos, the best photos plus the control shot. So yun dapat. Yung control shot, wala ng caption yun. Hindi na lalagyan ng caption. Yung lalagyan lamang ng caption ay yung 5 best pictures niya or best shots o photos na kanyang kinunan. Yun ang lalagyan lamang ng captions. Okay, number 4. Contestants shall retain in the memory card photos to be submitted only. Sabi ko kanina, yung 6 photos lamang yung dapat matitira doon sa memory card. Number 5. Contestants will be given 30 minutes to write captions for each of the 5 photos. So tandaan na, 30 minutes. Although during the SPC, kung minsan maabot din ng isang oras. Dahil yung iba, o ito, please remember this one. Ang atong mga photojournalists should bring their own laptops. Itong problema, kasi yung iba walang laptop. Kasi doon sila magli-layout. Doon nila ili-layout yung kanilang mga pictures. Pwede rin naman kasi hindi na yun i-preprint. Titingnan na lamang kung anong nandun sa kanilang laptop. Okay. And usually, yung mga best na mga output, yun muna ang matitira. So kung halimbawa yung estudyante nyo, your contestant, yung laptop niya na remain doon sa room, meaning may posibilidad mananalo siya. Kapag halimbawa yung mga estudyante mo, yung contestant mo lumabas, dala-dala na yung laptop, meaning wala na, wala ng pag-asa. Kasi titingnan pa kasi doon kung ano talaga yung rank ng bata para maging fair yung judging. So titingnan muna yung best outputs, then yun, iko-compare na yung pinaka-best para malaman na yung ranking ng bawat isa. Okay. So again, 30 minutes lamang, especially in SPC, kay stricto sila doon when it comes to time. So, mas mabuti dito sa DSPC kasi we give consideration. So, about in the national. Okay, number 6. Caption sheets with lines. Okay, parang hindi tayo gumagamit dito in the lower competition. So, punta na lamang tayo sa number 7. So, ibig sabihin may binibigay silang mga papel doon. Number 7. All entries with caption sheets shall be submitted to the examiner after the allotted time. Okay, yun ang sinasabi natin kanina. Number 8. Memory cards per region will be returned to the participants through their educational program supervisor in charge of campus journalism after the closing program. So, this will happen during national press conference. But then, in the division, press con, so right after the kuan, the contest, binibigay kaagad sa bata yung kanilang memory card. In the region, regional press con, doon sa ating in charge na lang sa yung sa campus journalism or yung in charge sa pagkuha ng tinatawag nating mga memory cards. Kasi yung iba nawawala yung ibang memory cards. And then number 9, during the duration of the competition, this is very important, advisors, trainers, and parents are not allowed in the venue. So tayong mga adviser, kayong mga adviser dyan, huwag nang sunod ng sunod sa mga bata. Okay? So kasi contest na. So huwag nang tuturuan pa yung bata anong gagawin. So meaning, as early as now, we have to train our photojournalists how to take pictures and also how to caption. Para at least, sigurado tayo na mananalo yung ating mga bata when it comes to the competitions na. Division, regional, and hopefully, papunta doon sa national press conference. Okay, I'm going to show you the score sheet for photojournalism. Para at least alam nyo, you'll be guided. Ano ba yung ginagamit na score sheet? Kumbaga, para malaman kung sino ang mapanalo. So we have the technical or quality. This is 40%. So malaki to, mataas yung percentage para dito. So exposure, value, and quality of image. So kanina nabanggit na ni Sir, paano ba ang pagkuha ng magandang image ng larawan? Okay, number two, presents images with acceptable sharpness. Ibig sabihin malinaw, hindi malabo yung larawan natin. That's for the technical quality, 40%. Then communicative quality, 40% again. Shows clear and specific ideas or angle connected to the theme or topic. So dapat may pinto yung larawan. Malinaw yung pinto ng larawan o ang idea ng larawan. Then uses creative photography techniques to highlight the visual story. So doon lalabas na sa communicative quality yung creativity. Sabi nga natin kanina, yung mga ginagamit nating mga principles in taking pictures, tinatawag din natin framing at kung ano-ano pa dyan, the rule of thirds at kung ano-ano pa dyan. So yung nabanggit kanina ni Sir Gerald, okay, so yun, ma-apply na dito sa communicative quality, which is 40% sa ating rating. Then for news caption, although this is only 10%, mahalaga rin to. How about kung talagang tikit yung competition? Tapos yung sa'yo, maganda naman yung caption mo, tapos yung isa hindi. So siyempre, pa ikaw, mananalo, di ba? So news caption, 10%. So right, a 2-sentence news. So ito yung kinuha ko doon sa ating, one, sa ating guidelines. Okay, dahil sa nakapag-download ako ng guidelines, 2020 na kuan na NSPC, at yun ang nakasulat doon. So right, a 2-sentence news caption per photo following the 5W namang, 5W at saka yung 1H question. So, the 5W and 1H question should be answered in our caption, in the captioning. Okay. Then, for the ethics, which is also 10%, observes ethical and professional standards for journalism, fairness and accuracy. Then, respectful of subjects' right to privacy. So, bawal dito nudity, no permission to the subject. Nakuha ka lang ng larawan pagkatapos, hindi ka nagtanong kung pwede ba siyang kuna ng larawan o hindi. Then, follows strict standards of no manipulation and alteration of reality. Nabanggit na yan ni Sir kanina, bawal ang pag-crack-crap ng picture. Diba? So, dapat kung ano ang nakunan mong larawan, yun na dapat ang makikita doon sa inyong output. So, total is 100%. So, I'm going to show you, ito yung output ko nung nagkaroon tayo ng regional training in photojournalism. Makikita nyo sa larawan, ito yung tungkol sa sports kasi I am one also of the kuan. Ano to? Officiating officials in athletics. Kaya mapapansin niyo rito, mayroon dito ng athletics na game and I happen also to come here in the division office during that time and I watched the taekwondo. Kaya yun ang kinunan kong larawan. So I have here picture, taekwondo at saka yung picture in athletics. So ang akin ditong catchline is go for gold. Tapos ang akin ditong, hindi ko sinasabing ito yung best ha? I'm just showing you as example. Okay. So at itab area 2A kicks for victory against area 1 opponent in the Taekwondo Championship during the Provincial Athletic Meet held at Athletic Division Gym February 10, 2023. Okay. Tapos ito naman, small but terrible. Bakit itong picture ko? Bakit mayroon ditong isang tao, isang runner din? My purpose is para makita na talagang maliit yung batang to. Kaya nga, my catchline is small but terrible. Grade 4 runner of area 4 nails and approximately 15 meter lead in 800 meter run finals during the Provincial Athletic Meet held at Athletic Sports Complex at Global City February 10 morning. Okay, so yun ang caption na ginawa ko. Ito rin ang nasubmit ko doon sa regional nating training. Okay, iwan ko anong nangyari. Okay, so I'm just showing you ha, an example, hindi ko sinasabing ito yung best. But at least, it is my own work. Hindi ko kinuha sa kung saan-saan. Okay, kayo nang bahalang mag-critic kung tama o mali. Okay, so ito naman, gumamit ako rito ng kuan, ng feature. Okay, sa feature to, in our billeting. Sa billeting quarters namin. So recycling is the key. Ito yung ginamit ko. Yung ginamit ko rito yung frame, yung sanga-sanga. Yung dahon, yung may halaman kasi doon, yung kalipayan, yun ang ginamit kong frame. Tapos sa gitna, yun ang mga plastic. Okay, mga plastic container. So it is a responsibility of everyone to recycle solid waste into useful materials in order to have a cleaner and greener environment. Dito naman, sa totoo lang, itong pedicab driver, alam ko naman na hindi yan magpapakuha ng larawan. So, ang ginawa ko, I just focused my cellphone na gamit ko. Bawat nagdaraan na mapedicab, pinipicturan ko it at knowing nga, pinipicturan ko sila. Maraming beses itong ginawa. Hanggang sa nakakuha talaga ko ng picture na ganito na. Okay. So, pasensya na kung sino man siya. Walang paalam. Pero at least, nakatalikod naman, hindi naman nakaharap. So, pedicab driver, sabali ang aking catchline dito is struggle. A PDCAB driver endures the heat of the sun in order to support his family, especially in these times of crisis. So, bali yun ang aking caption. And then, I don't know if you will be intrigued with this caption. Kasi ito, mapapansin nyo kasi, ito'y kuan lang. Kung baga covered court. Oh, ito, covered court ba? Yung covered walk. Okay, yung ginawa ko rito, kasi may, in my mind, gusto ko ipakita about life. Sabi ko, may picture, pwede sana may tao naglalakad in that covered walk. Pero sige lang, that's my idea. So, ginawa ko rito, life is a journey. So, sabi ko, man experiences the bright and dark sides. Kasi, in my right, in the right side, bright man siya. And in the left side, dark man siya. White paint, di ba? Tapos itong na ang color niya. Okay. So, yun na, that's my interpretation. So, man experiences the bright and dark sides of life and passes through a trail of obstacles. So, ginawa kang obstacle yan and challenges before reaching his dream. Yung dream niya, yung nandun sa dulo. Kung ano man yun, hindi ko alam. Okay, that's my idea about the picture. Okay, and again, hindi ko sinasabing the best ito ha. This is only my output during the regional training. Okay, so let me end with this quote from Craig Coverdale. There are things hidden for all the world until photographed.